Today is the delivery day for our PD resistant selections, 8 of the PD resistant selections that are 97% vinifera, highly resistant in our greenhouse trials, and we're ready to field trial them now. They'll be planted tomorrow at Silverado Vineyards here in near the Yountville area along the Napa River, where there's been historically extremely intense pressure. And we've taken out this 6 rows of vines and going to replace them with our selections in five pine vine sets. And then have a bunch of Chardonnay in here as well to verify we're getting good infection and spread of the bacteria. It's now November, middle of November, so this is the first season's growth. A lot of unevenness to the plot. It consists of about 7 or 8 of our most advanced selections in the 94 and 97% vinifera. And it also has about an equal number of Chardonnay plants in here to make sure that we have even infection across the plot. The infection's coming from the Napa River here off to the west, and it's flowing in with the vectors and attacking these plants. We'll be inoculating them too, I hope. That'll be a little bit to do with the very kind, generous support of Silverado Vineyards here and Walsh Vineyard Management, who are going to let us, I hope, inoculate these vines too. But they'll be receiving the pressure from the creek anyway. This is an area that they really can't grow vinifera cultivars along in any longer. It's just a waste of their time. They're constantly replanting them. So perfect spot for us, maybe not the best spot for them. Again, these are varieties that we'll hope will be blending into standard traditional varieties and allowing people to reuse these properties and have PD resistant material that they can blend in with Chardonnay or Cabernet or other varieties. So we're at the point now where we're going to start releasing some of these materials. We really don't have the capacity to start growing vineyard level amounts of this. We're going to have to convince growers to use some of these to get them out into really commercial scale plantings. We're hoping to release the first a couple of varieties this spring, winter, through Foundation Plant Services. They'll be going to nurseries then. They'll build up for a couple of years in nursery plantings, and then they'll be ready to graft and propagate for growers. I know there'll be intense interest in Texas and Alabama. Hopefully areas like this plot here will also be quite interested in planting these, and along the Dry Creek Valley area as well, where Pierce disease is quite severe. Again, they'll be mostly used as blending grapes. They'll be taking these materials and blending them in with standard cultivars. We're just now beginning to grapple with the idea of how to name these. If you're going to use them in a varietal sense, where they're really standalone and not blended, we'll have to come up with some catchy names. When they're blended, I don't think it's going to matter very much. Those names won't be very important. They'll be blended with Chardonnay and Merlot and Cabernet and Pinot and these sorts of areas. We won't really see a huge demand for a special name. And it may be that the name can be fairly whimsical and maybe a bit offbeat for the South as well, since those are going to be different sorts of wines, not really competing with California or European vinifera wines. So we have high hopes for the first ones, and we have probably as many as 30 or 40 capable of release over the next 5+ years, I hope, 5 to 10 years, as we get more and more information about the more advanced selections. We're doing our best to make sure we're releasing only the things with the highest level of resistance, so that helps a lot. We know that you can have a fairly broad tolerance to the bacterium and still be field resistant, but we know that those materials will host a fair amount of bacteria in those same sort of vines. So we're selecting for the ones that have the highest resistance, and those are the ones we'll be releasing to prevent them from being hosts. We're actually moving the bacteria further back into a susceptible vineyard sort of planting nearby.